Hello, welcome again. We are covering aerospace engineering syllabus. The section one is engineering mathematics and core topic is engineering. Now our subtopic is shortcut method to find to check the consistency of linear equation. So we have discussed linear equation in the last video. So this A is your coefficient matrix A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A3. 2 and 8 is here the elements of the coefficient matrix, and this is your augmented matrix. Just last column is k1, k2, k3, and otherwise it is your coefficient matrix. Okay, so now to check the consistency, we will operate the augmented matrix, and after performing various operations, if we arrive at this result that one of this row is 0, okay, then then it will have infinite solution. Okay, or we can say all the elements of one row are zero, then it will have infinite number of solutions. Okay, so if it doesn't happen and all the element of so coefficient matrix is zero, but the augmented matrix has one element as non-zero for which all the other elements of the row are 0, okay, like that, okay. Then it will have no solution, okay. And the third possibility, when the coefficient matrix have one non-zero and other elements are 0 in one row, and augmented matrix has 0 or non-zero, can have any value for that row, okay. Then it will have unique solution. So we'll solve one example for that. For example, is investigate the value of lambda and mu so that the equation 2x plus 3y plus 5z is equal to 9. Second equation 7x plus 3y minus 2z is equal to 8. Third equation 2x plus 3y plus lambda z is equal to mu. I have one no solution, two a unique solution, 3 and infinite number of solutions. So this is your coefficient matrix, and these three equations can be written like this. Okay, 2, 3, 5, 7, 3, minus 2, 2, 3, lambda, x, y, z, and equal to 9, 8. Okay, so now if we analyze that here the first row for the coefficient matrix is 2, 3, 5, and here it is 2, 3, and third is lambda. If lambda is equal to 5, then we operate r1 minus r3, then one of the row of the coefficient matrix will be 0. Okay, so it means if lambda is 5, okay, if lambda is 5, then this case or this case may occur. So in this case it will have infinite solution, and in this case it will have no solution if lambda is 5. Okay, but for unique solution lambda should not be equal to 5. So if lambda is 5, then it will have either infinite number of solution or no solution. Okay, if lambda is not equal to 5, then it will have unique solution. Okay, and mu may have any value for lambda is equal to 5, not equal to 5, to have unique solution. Okay, so now if lambda is 5, then there are two possibilities. Then this row will become 0, this row will become 0. So okay, and if we analyze that here 9 is there, if mu is equal to 9, then this row will be equal to 0. So then bottom row will be your, if you create this augmented matrix 2, 3, 5, 9 and take mu is equal to 9, 2, 3, 5, mu is equal to 9, then this row will be 0. Okay, so it means all the element of one row of the augmented matrix will be 0, then it will have infinite number of solutions. So mu will be equal to 9. Okay, if mu is equal to 9, then it will have infinite solution. If mu is not equal to 9 and lambda is equal to 5, then it will have no solution. So lambda not equal to pi will, it will have unique solution. Lambda is equal to 5 and mu is not equal to 9. It will have no solution, and lambda is equal to 5, mu is equal to 9. The system has infinite number of solutions.